everyone, it's Ezra speaking here. Do I have a Christmas present for you? Well, here it is, everyone's favorite holiday classic, A Charlie Brown Christmas, written by Charles Schultz. Has warmed the hearts of million fans since it first aired on television over 55 years ago. Now the classic animated television special comes to life in this faithful stage adaptation that celebrates the timeless television classic, so the whole family can join Charlie Brown, Snoopy, Lucy, Linus, and the rest of the Peanuts characters in their journey to uncover the true meaning of Christmas.
What is it you want?
Real estate.
Welcome to Real Life Charlie Brown, Ethan Davenport, and Lucy, Leah, Windahl, to the Ezra Speaking Show today. How are you guys, Ethan and Leah?
Pretty good.
Doing great.
How are you?
I'm doing very good today. Fantastic. Thank you so much for getting up early to be getting to hang out with me today.
Anytime.
Of course.
How are the shows going?
Really great. We've only had one so far. And then we had a couple days off, which was great because we rehearsed for a very long time with no breaks. But shows have been great. We had a lot of fun.
Yeah. Thanks for the update. Would you like to play some A Charlie Brown Christmas trivia?
Yes. Sure. I'd love to do that.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Here's the first question. Pigpen is the only person that Charlie Brown knows who can do what?
I think I know this one. Raise a cloud of dust in a snowstorm.
True. Yes, correct. Lucy was kissed once during this show. Who kissed her?
Snoopy.
Snoopy.
Kissed by a dog.
No, that's the lucky feller.
She has dog germs.
What traditional carol does the entire Peanuts gang hum and then eventually sing at the end of the show?
Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Yes.
Did we get it?
Questions. Yes. So that's the end of the trivia. Thank you so much. Now I have some questions for you guys today. In addition to performing, Leah, you enjoy unsolving mysteries, reading, and buying the weirdest records at the thrift store. What is the weirdest record you've ever bought?
Okay. So I'm from Cleveland, Ohio, and I bought a record that it was like unlabeled, and it was, I bought it for like 40 cents, and it was an all Catholic girls' schools production of The King and I. And I wrote a blog post about it, and the woman who played the king, found my blog post, and I was able to give the record back to her because she lost it. So it's very cool.
That's wild.
Yeah. That's the weirdest one.
And then Ethan, I hear you have the skill of speaking American Southern, Australian, and Minnesota accents. Would you say some lines or fun things in those accents?
Crikey. I'm from Minnesota, so anything I say, I guess it counts. But, you know, you can kind of ham it up here. Okay, how's it going there? You know, Charles Schultz and all that.
That's pretty good.
I liked it.
Great.
Excellent.
So, now, besides having everyone come see your awesome show, what do you guys want for Christmas?
Oh, no.
That's a tough question. What do I want for Christmas?
Maybe Lucy wants real estates in real life.
I know, right?
I want to go home and see my pets. That's what I want for Christmas.
She has been talking about her cats.
Yeah, I won't stop talking about my cats. So that's what I want, is to go look at my cats.
I think for me, I'd like to go home and just, you know, spend some time with family and have a good home-cooked meal.
Mm.
You want a meal with your family?
Yes.
That sounds like a great gift. I would love that, too. Well, I can't have that like every day.
Right. It's not as fun for you.
Right.
Speaking of real Charlie Brown Christmas tree, tell me about one of your favorite Christmas traditions.
I mean, my favorite is, so my mom's whole side of the family, we all spend the night at my grandma's house, and we've been doing that my whole life. So that is something I'm really looking forward to, and very fun.
Now, Ethan?
Let's see. You know, I think I like the stockings. I just think it's fun. The sort of the theme of putting the stockings up, and then you get to all, you get the all the little gifts. I like those better than like one giant gift.
Yes. Because one giant gift is just one big present, and then the stocking Santa just stuffs up toys and little stuff and
Exactly.
Like poppets, scrunchies, whatever.
Yeah, tic-tacs, anything. Mm-hmm.
Now, next question. A Charlie Brown Christmas seems to have a deeper message than your average cartoon. And I think in part, that is what has kept the story alive and relevant for 50 plus years. What have you learned about the true meaning of Christmas since the beginning part of the show?
Well, I think it's kind of like Linus says, it's like, it's not about commercialism. It's about peace, goodwill towards men. So it's about being nice to each other instead of just like getting a big fancy Christmas tree.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Like, you know, acceptance of yourself, acceptance of others, and celebrating each other and the relationships you have with people.
Yeah. If someone watching would like to do a musical theater when they grow up, what would you recommend them to do to best prepare themselves, experiences and education-wise?
Hmm. I mean, I would just say just get involved. You know, I started doing theater when I was in fourth grade and really never missed an opportunity to do that. But it's also never too late to start. So,
yeah. I think just surround yourself with music and take in media, go see plays.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you feel like you're ready, take the jump and go do a community theater show. That's where I started. I think most people start there, and it's a great way to just, you know, it doesn't have to be professional to be really impactful and really, really fun.
Mm-hmm. That was awesome. Thank you so much for that. After the final bow, crescendo into a celebration as the audience is invited to join the Peanuts game in singing traditional Christmas songs and carols. Can we sing Hark the Herald Angels Sing?
Yes.
Sure.
Give me one sec.
Probably going to start with that Snoopy.
Do you see how it says C&L? Well, that's Charlie Brown and Lucy. Okay. I'm going to sing Hark the Angels Herald Sing, and then I'll Hark the Angels Herald Sing, glory to the newborn King, and then I'll sing the Ezra, you sing, you guys will sing the C&L, and I'll sing the Ezra, okay? Okay.
Absolutely.
Until the end.
All right.
You guys can start.
Okay.
Right? Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King.
Peace on earth and see the child, God is there, is reconciled.
Joyful all ye nations rise.
Joyful of the skies. Skies.
Angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem.
Glory to the newborn King. Glory to... Now we all sing, glory to the newborn King.
Game.
Awesome.
Ezra, you could be on the show.
Yeah, you're a natural.
Okay. How'd you guys like that?
That was fun.
A lot of fun.
Well, I'm definitely in the Christmas spirit now. I think I'll go home and put up my tree. I have a little fake Christmas tree.
Nice.
in my I have a little Christmas tree that every year I put it up in my room. Thanks so much, Ethan Davenport, who plays Charlie Brown, and Leah Windahl, who plays Lucy. In the live action adaptation, A Charlie Brown Christmas. Everyone, A Charlie Brown Christmas, live on stage, is a present the whole family can enjoy. There's no better way for both among children and adults to discover the magic of season. Please come to see them December 21st right here in Indianapolis at Butler's Cruise Hall, or check out acharliebrownchristmaslive.com to find a show near you. And please subscribe to my YouTube channel, Ezra Speaking, and follow me on Facebook as well, please. Thanks so much. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Subscribe.
Thanks. Thank you for having us.
Thank you.